Hi students, good morning everyone. So in our last class we have discussed about the independence of the attribute. So when the attributes are not related to each other, they are said to be independent, right? And we have seen the three criteria for the independence of attributes. Now today we will see the next topic in the theory of attributes, that is association of attributes. So today we will discuss what is association of attributes and what are different criteria under the association. So what does association mean? Association means associated with each other. That means they are related to each other. So whenever the attributes are not independent, they are said to be associated in some or other way. So it may be in any way, then the attributes are said to be associated. So what does association mean? If attributes are not independent, if attributes are not independent, so we have studied the criteria for the independence. If that criteria does not satisfy, then the attributes are said to be associated. Now, coming to the association of attributes, so there are two types of associations. So, coming to the types of associations, so basically there are two types of associations. First one is complete association. That is complete association and complete disassociation. So coming to complete association means here if we have two attributes. If we consider the two attributes, suppose A and B. So whenever I consider the two attributes A and B, then they are said to be completely associated if A cannot occur without B. A cannot occur without B. So here the attribute A cannot occur without B. So that means the attribute A occurs only if the attribute B occurs. So the attribute A cannot occur without B, though B may occur without A. B may occur without A. So we said that A cannot occur without B. So A cannot occur without B, though, but the reverse, that is B may occur without A. So this is a condition for complete association. So whenever you consider two qualities or two attributes A and B, so A cannot occur without B. So if you want the attribute A to occur, so first B has to occur. The B may occur without A. But since here A is dependent on the B values, so that's why A will occur only after happening of the B. But B is not dependent on A, so that's why B may occur without A also. Similarly, here they are said to be, here I have considered that A cannot occur without B. So the vice versa will also be true, that is B cannot occur without A. So from these two conditions, if anyone satisfies, that is a complete association. B cannot occur without A, though A may occur without B. Though A may occur without B. So the vice versa will also be true, that is A cannot occur without B, and similarly the next, if you consider the other attributes, B can So simply I'm just saying that suppose how you will be getting the health issues if you don't take a proper food, then you will get the health issues. Suppose if I'm considering A as some health issue. So how I will get the health issue? Because I may not take the proper food. If I have an improper food, so here health issues, that is A, cannot occur without B. So if I have an improper food, then only I will get the health issues, like that. A cannot occur without B, but the reverse may be B cannot occur without A, that can happen. So improper food, it doesn't only mean health issue, right? It may be any other thing also. Improper food, it is independent. Now this is complete association. Hope you understood it. If you have any doubts, be clear. We will discuss in live class also. And next, now we will study the complete disassociation. So coming to complete disassociation. So complete disassociation means you are having two attributes A and B. So the attributes are said to be disassociated if there is no A's in B's. So no A's in B's means there are no A values in the B values. That means there is no common thing in this values. That indicates that AB is equals to 0. So if AB equals to 0, that is said to be the complete disassociation. Or there are, if you consider the complementaries also, there are no alphas in betas. So that means alpha beta is equal to 0. So if there are no A's in B's, that means in our B values we don't have any A values. That means the common terms are not present. That indicates that the common class for A and B is nothing but AB. So there is no common frequency for AB, that's why the class frequency of AB will be equals to 0. Similarly, the complementaries also, there will be no alphas in betas. That means the class frequency of alpha beta is equals to 0. So this is about the complete association and complete disassociation. Now, similarly, like the independence of the attribute, here also for the association of attributes, we are having some criteria. So, to know the criteria of the association, you have to clearly remember the independence of attribute criteria also. Because whenever they are not independent, then only they are said to be associated, right? So that's why based on that criteria only, we are going to write the criteria for the association. Now we will see the criteria of the association. So mainly we will be having two criteria here. Oh, that two criteria are based on the two criteria. First two criteria of the independence of the attributes. So coming to the criteria of association. So we will discuss the criteria 1 now.
Equals to A beta by beta.
So this is the criteria one for the independence of the attribute, right? So if this condition does not satisfy, if this value is not equal, both proportions are not equal, then they are said to be associated, right? So then AB by B greater than, if that value is greater than AB term by B term, then they are positively associated. Positively associated. Similarly, if this value, that is AB by B, is less than AB term by B term, then they are negatively associated. So this criteria 1 is similar to the criteria 1 of the independence of attributes. You have to remember the symbolic representation of the criteria 1 in independence of attributes. So that means, what is the symbolic representation in criteria 1 of independence of attributes? AB by B is not equal, is equals to A beta by beta. So association means, if this condition is not satisfied, then they are said to be associated. So not satisfied means this value is not equals to the this value. So not equal to means it may be either greater than or either it may be less than. So if AB by B is greater than A beta by B, then they are positively associated. Similarly, if AB by B is less than A beta by beta, then they are said to be negatively associated. So whenever you have a question related to association or independence, first you have to find these values, AB by B, A beta by B. So if they are equal, they are independent. If it is greater, they are positively associated. If it is less than, then it is negatively associated. Now we will be seeing the second criteria. So what is the second criteria in the independence of attribute? Similar to that criteria only, you will be having the criteria 2. So what is the second criteria in independence of attributes? That is AB equals to the proportions we took. Proportion of AB to the whole population is equals to AB by N. This you have also written as AB by N equals to A by N into B by N. So this is the condition for the independence of attributes. So whenever two attributes are independent, AB is equals to A into B by capital N. So this condition is not satisfied, then they are said to be associated, right? So not satisfied means, here the attributes A and B are associated if, so what are the conditions? First one is AB is greater than A into B by capital N. So if this condition satisfies, that is AB is greater than AB by N, then they are positively associated. So this is the condition for the positive association. Similarly, if this value is greater, less than, that is AB is less than AB by capital N, then they are negatively associated. They are negatively associated. So if this value is equals to 0, that means this condition, if it satisfies, that is AB equals to AB by N, then they are independent. So the best way to check the independence or association is by using this criteria 2. Because in criteria 1, the The complementary negative arguments are also there. So if depending on your data, which values are given, you will be using the criteria 1 or the criteria 2. So here this criteria 2 of the association of attributes is very similar to the criteria 2 of the independence of the attributes. So what is this criteria 2? Remember this criteria, that is AB is equal to A into B by capital N. So based on this value, association means this condition should not satisfy. It did not satisfy means it is either greater or either less. If it is greater than, if AB is greater than AB by N, then they are positively associated. Similarly, if AB is less than AB by N, they are negatively associated. So these are the two criteria for the association of attributes. Association means if they are not independent, they are said to be associated. And we have seen complete association and complete disassociation. And next, the two criteria are also given, that is dependent on the criteria of the independence of attributes. Now we will see the next one, that is we will see a few problems related to independence and association. So in the last class also we have seen a problem related to some problems related to independence of and the association the problems we will be seeing now. Coming to the question, it is given that in a sample of 1000 individuals, so there are total 1000 values, that is population size is 1000, 100 possess attribute A. So out of 1000, the 100 people possess the attribute A and 300 possess attribute B. So out of 1000, 300 possess attribute B. And we have to find how many individuals possess both A and B and how many possess neither if A and B are independent. So condition in the question is given that A and B are independent. So this is the question related to the independence of attributes. So coming to the solution, first write given the population size, that is n equals to, what is the n value? 1000. Next it is given that 100 possess attribute A. So 100 people possessing attribute A means the class frequency of A is given as A class frequency equals to 100. Similarly, 300 possess attribute B. So 300 possess attribute B is the class frequency of B equals to 300. And what we have to find, how many individuals possess both A and B. So we have to find the class frequency of AB and we have to find that both AB and how many possess neither A or B. So neither A or B means the complementaries of A and B are what? Alpha and beta. So we need to find these two values, that is AB and alpha beta values. Under the condition, what is the condition given? If A and B are independent. So if two attributes A and B are independent, if two attributes A and B are independent, so which criteria we will be seeing here? Because only A, B and ABs are given, we have to estimate the AB value also. So we will be considering the criteria 2. What is the criteria 2? AB is equals to AB by capital N. So similarly, if alpha and beta are also independent, then how we will be writing the conditions according to criteria 2? That is alpha beta is equals to alpha into beta divided by capital N. So to find AB value, I'm AB and alpha beta value. I'm considering the criteria 2 of the independence of attributes. So here AB value I can find and alpha beta value. To find this alpha beta value, first I need alpha and beta values. So from the given question, A is given, B is given and capital N value is given. So from that data, can I calculate alpha and beta values? Yes. So we know that A plus alpha equals to capital N. What is the A value given? 100 plus alpha equals to N value is 1000. So from this, what is the alpha value? Alpha equals to 1000 minus 100 is 900. So similarly, we also know that B plus beta equals to capital N. What is the B value given in the question? 300. So 300 plus beta value we have to find. 300 plus beta equals to 1000. That means that beta value equals to 1000 minus 300 is 700. Now we got the alpha and beta values. Now we will find the AB and alpha beta values. Now consider AB equals to A into B by capital N. Substitute the values. What is the A value? A value is 100 into B value is 300 divided by, what is the capital N value? Capital N value is 1000. So if you cancel, you will be getting the AB value as 10 into 3 is 30. Now we got the AB value. Similarly, we find out the alpha beta value also. How to find the alpha beta value? Alpha into beta divided by capital N. What is the alpha value we got? 900 into beta value, we got it as 30 people possess the attribute A and B, and neither means alpha beta, that is 630 people possess the people neither possess A or not possess B. So that is alpha beta value 630. So we will see the next problem. Independent or associated. Now coming to the next question. Here the given data is, if A equals to 450 and B class frequency equals to 650, the class frequency of AB equals to 310 and capital N equals to 1000, find whether A and B are independent or associated. So first write down given class frequency of A equals to 450, class frequency of B equals to 650, capital N equals to 1000. Similarly, the class frequency of AB equals to 310. So how we will be checking from the given data? AB values are given, A is given, B is given. So we will be finding AB. So if AB equals to A
remain.
Similarly, if AB is greater than A into B by capital N, then what is the condition? Then A and B are positively associated. Similarly, if AB is less than A into B by capital N, then A and B are negatively associated. Suppose we have to check whether this AB value is equals to A into B by capital N or not. Now for consider AB equals to A into B by capital N. What is the AB value given? 310 is equals to, what is the AB value? A is 450 into B is 650 divided by 1000. So 45 into 65 divided by 10, you will be getting the answer as 292.5. So we have considered the AB into a final value that is equals to 292.5. So now what is the AB value given here? Since AB value equals to, what is the value? 310 is not equals to AB, A into B by capital N. So they are not independent. So here we can conclude that they are not independent. And we will check whether they are associated. Yes, if they are not independent, they are associated. So they are positively or negatively associated. So here AB equals to 310 is greater than A into B by capital N, which is equals to 292.5. So since AB is greater than A into B by capital N, therefore the attributes A and B are positively associated. So this is the problem related to positive associations. So today we have seen what is association, the types of association, and the two criteria for the association, and we have seen two problems related to the association and the independent of attributes. In the next class, we will be studying the measures of association. So don't miss tomorrow's class. It's an important question. So in the measures, that means how we will be measuring the association of attributes. So we know the attributes are positive or negative, but how to measure those attributes, we will be studying in our next class.